The air is the other fluid of Earth, spinning and flowing, rising and falling. Animals of nature have long used these currents to soar beyond the earthly pull of gravity, and recently, so has man. There is something magical about seeing an aircraft fly without the aid of an engine, silently carving the sky in balance with gravity and rising air. Radio-controlled soaring offers the pilot the thrill and beauty of powerless flight while keeping one's feet firmly and safely on the ground. Flying sailplanes is fun and addicting, and this film features soaring pilots having a blast at some of the best flying sites and contests on the West Coast. Sit back and prepare for launch. One of the busiest RC soaring sites in the United States is the Torrey Pines Gliderport in San Diego, California. Its sheer cliffs and consistent sea breezes make for great lift for soaring machines of all types. Here is sailplane designer Charlie Richardson doing some aerobatics with one of his own creations. He is one of the smoothest pilots I have ever filmed. Equally skillful is Dan Peterson flying a turbo wingeron plane. Very few pilots can fly radical aerobatics like he can. Both wings on his Turbo S rotate independently, allowing for very fast rolls and spins. Dan flies helicopters too. Even this experienced pilot can push the limits a bit too far. It's hard throwing a few hundred dollars off a 350-foot cliff. You can see all types of planes flying at Torrey Pines. Here is a gorgeous all-wood Schweitzer 126 built from scratch. One of the great innovations in the sport is the use of EPP foam in the construction of gliders. This dense plastic foam is very hard to damage and can be shaped into any design. When these planes crash, they bounce. It was only natural to shape this material into replica combat planes, which could dogfight all day without damage. There is nothing more fun than smashing your opponent in air-to-air combat. This is the hill at Laguna Niguel in Orange County, California, where foamy combat was pioneered. Indestructible foamies have revolutionized the sometimes difficult flight training process. For anyone wanting to learn to fly, a foamy trainer is the only way to go. The Visalia Thermal Duration Soaring Meet, held every October in California's Central Valley, is one of the largest soaring contests in the world, hosting over 250 pilots and vendors from all over the U.S. Keeping the frequencies organized and the winches running for over 1,000 launches a day is quite a task. It is always sunny at this contest, and the lift is always plentiful.
Ready on one, that
This contest is won and lost in the landings. Here are some good and not so good attempts at hitting the circle. Visalia is known for its friendly people, great barbecues, unusual entertainment, and great fun flying till midnight. This is an event not to be missed. For the pilot who feels the need for speed, slope racing is the ultimate test of flying skill. Smooth turns, energy management, good tactics, nerves of steel, and a fast plane are the requirements for winning slope races. Racers get 1 minute to gain altitude and must enter the course and complete a number of laps between two sets of pylons. Top pilots Steve New and Eric Larson battle in a match race at Torrey Pines. Accidents do happen. They called me Mr. Smooth at Torrey Pines. This is my Renegade cruising to another victory. Here are some of the boys practicing for the weekend's race. This is some vintage racing footage from the 1994 World Soaring Jamboree at Kiona Butte, Washington. Racing at an inland slope site is more challenging than racing at the coast. The lift is not as smooth, and thermals rising up from the valley floor can quickly change course conditions. Choosing the right amount of ballast and adjusting your flying style for the variable conditions are keys to winning. Every racer hopes for that perfect extreme day when the winds are high and the planes are heavy and fast. The 1997 International Slope Race, held at Davenport, California, featured 2 days of incredible racing conditions. Between my heats, I was able to capture some great racing footage of top slope racer and world F3B champion, Daryl Perkins. His smooth flying technique made him impossible to beat. A couple of pilots gave him a good race, though. This is unlimited slope racing at its best. One of my favorite types of soaring is with a hand-launch glider. These lightweight planes are designed to catch thermals from a hard throw. On a good day, you can get flights of a half hour or more. You are watching action from the annual International Hand Launch Festival, held every year in San Diego. The best hand launch pilots in the country convene to compete in this 2-day contest to test their precision flying skills. 2-time international winner Joe Wurts shows his contest-winning throws. Thank you. Hand launch gliders are the purest form of RC soaring, and flying them is a zen experience, allowing the pilot to truly experience the energy of the air. There is not one pilot who has not wished he could strap himself into his model and go for a ride. Here is what it might look like on such a flight. I have my camcorder bolted to my big unlimited slope racer, and it is cruising the small cliffs of Carlsbad, California. Torrey Pines also looks great from the air. This is what a slope race looks like from the plane's perspective. Not all of the flights ended smoothly. Beer sick bags are under your seat. This plane is not slope flying on the windward side of the hill. The newest sensation in flying is dynamic soaring, a technique perfected by world soaring champion Joe Wurts. Using the separation boundary of air flowing over the backside of a sharp peak, the pilot can accelerate his plane to incredible speeds. Here's Joe demonstrating dynamic soaring with an EPP Combat flying wing at Parker Mountain, north of Los Angeles. Thanks to John Rowe, who provided endless lift with his great footage. This is Joe's fast F3B plane in some very light winds, but still gaining some impressive speeds. On another day with much stronger winds, Joe really lets his plane rip. This video is not speeded up. This video, shot by Ray Gross, shows ace pilot Doug Reel trying some extreme dynamic soaring in 50 knot Santa Ana winds with a fully ballasted slope racer. He soon reaches the structural limits of his wings at well over 120 miles an hour. We'll be right back. Sometimes your plane pays the price of exploring the outer edges of the envelope, but you have fun anyway. Traveling to a new flying spot or event is one of my favorite things to do. This is the stunning Wallowa Lake area in Northeast Oregon, where Sailplane and Electric Magazine sponsors a fun fly every year. You can take a tram up Mount Howard for some high altitude slope and thermal flying, or visit some of the scenic slopes along the Snake River.
Yeah, we are in the slope in Mount Howard, and we have just been sloping in America. It is very good indeed.
This year, high pressure brought light winds and thunderstorms took out the road to the river sites, but the thermal flying was outstanding. The local airport is open for launching into the amazing Alpine lift. Some of the models were so big, we had to call in a bigger tow plane. Flying in this mountain wonderland was a treat for all. Some guys brought their slope on a rope for some exciting high G launches. Will Byers, publisher of the magazine, readies his unflown third scale Fox for aerotow. The passenger looks a bit nervous. This was one flight Will will never forget. Just as he lands, the wind shifts and a big thermal blows through, causing him to land too fast, first blowing the landing wheel off and putting this cameraman in danger of breaking his shins against the fiberglass wings of this big plane. Check out the jump. Sometimes engines are a good thing. Take a ride with me in a B-17 bomber embarking on a low-level bombing mission over San Diego. There's Torrey Pines. Bombs away! Now this is flying. Some flying days just stand out from others. Big Saturday, March 28, 1998, was one of those days at Torrey Pines. 40 to 50 knot winds blowing absolutely straight in brought out the best pilots and the fastest planes. This third scale Fox loves the strong conditions. High winds mean high speeds. Landings and takeoffs are very challenging in these conditions. Dave Sanders launches his beautiful foam Mustang into the big air. Sunday brought reduced winds and smoother conditions. Every pilot in town was at the cliff to enjoy this perfect Sunday. This B-24 was a crowd pleaser, especially when the battery went dead and she suffered a fatal crash. Soaring just doesn't get much better than this. I recently met with a band of hardcore slope flyers from Oregon and California at Oregon's Cape Blanco, which is renowned for its strong winds and stark beauty. The first day, I taught everybody how to dynamic soar, and from then on, more flying was done behind the slope than in front of it. Scott Hewitt gets the hang of DS flying with his Elvis wing. Cliff Lindgren tries some DS with his foamy Mustang. Dave Reese quickly picked up on dynamic soaring, and his zipper wing really screamed. He did this for hours on end. The fog often rolled in, showing us the elusive boundary layer. Even drizzle did not stop these slope maniacs from flying. DS slope racing is a blast. Crazy man Scott, with his Elvis, gets ready to rock and smoke. B-24 goes down smoking after being attacked by ME-163 foamies. I had all of this great footage left over from editing, and it was just too good not to show you. So here's a medley of some cool flying. A GB racer flies at Eagle Butte, proving that anything can fly given enough lift. Dan Peterson does some radical flying with his discus. Here I am at Ocean Shores, Washington, doing some F4W. If your electric winch is not strong enough for you, try the four-wheel drive variety. Cassette tape attached to the slope plane makes for a nice effect. I like a challenge, and flying under this bridge was great fun. This is some testing footage of my slope racer trying out some new wings. Some guys like to show off with camera and choke. Charlie Richardson carves up the bowl in classic style with his big F3 B-plane. The great thing about RC Soaring is that it never gets boring. Each flying day is unique, and you learn something new with every flight. Every sailplane has its own personality, and there are thousands of places to fly. I feel the magic of soaring every time I launch, and feel the endless forces of nature lifting my plane silently skyward.
Thank you. We'll be right back.
our most ambitious and educational video yet, Endless Lift 3 shows you soaring on the cutting edge with an hour and 23 minutes of the latest flying trends. This video also features some of the sport's top experts showing off the latest equipment and piloting techniques.